Well, she did make an interesting comment tangentially related to the bank. She said that she was open to easing qualitative tests for strong performers, and that's a reference, of course, to bank regulation. The KBE, the bank index, did move up a little bit on that. And, of course, anything reducing regulatory pressure on the banks would be a positive overall. So we saw a small move up in the bank stocks on that. Also, she made a very interesting comment on the labor market. She said the labor market is quite tight, and we may see pressure on wages. Now, this is some of the things that are really concerning people in the second half of the year, because margins are at a very high level right now for the S&P, about 10%. And wage pressure will erode the margins, and that would not be good for the overall markets. Although I personally, of course, would love to see wage pressure happening. But bottom line is a number of companies have already come out and said they're seeing some pressure on wages. Darden made a comment recently. FedEx made a comment about this. AutoZone also mentioned higher wages as a potential issue. So I think she's trying to get out ahead of that, even though it's still pretty modest so far. Those were the two things that I saw that I thought were most interesting in terms of the markets.
Yeah, I would also point out, in terms of the financials leading, it really is the investment banks and brokers that are the standout group. Morgan Stanley, Goldman Sachs, up more than 1%. Some of the retail brokers as well. That's been a strong group in the last month, last 3 months, really. Asset managers as well. So it's kind of a Wall Street trade, but who knows if there's also a little bit of a takeaway there that says, you know, all the questioning about potential regulatory relief maybe is holding up sentiment there.
Yeah, and remember, they're expected to be big performers in the second quarter, Mike. So technology is expected to be up double digits, the earnings, and financials are also about 8% on the upside here, hoping for a little bit of loan growth, a little bit of better trading activity. And while the spread in the yield spread is not very wide, it has started moving up a little bit on the short end, and that'll help the banks as well. So the two biggest sector, technology and the financials, are expected to have fairly decent earnings growth for the second quarter, and that's one of the reasons the markets have held up so
and
well.
Bob, tomorrow's going to be a big day with Citi, JPM, Wells, and PNC. Rick Santelli, earlier this morning you said that those who thought Yellen was advancing a hawkish agenda probably instead, you thought it was more like, you called it a Michael Jackson thing, where she was actually, looked like she was walking forward, but in fact you thought she was walking it back. Does today sort of ratify that view?
Well, I think it does. I think the best way to handicap what Janet Yellen yesterday or today, and today in particular, how anything she said has moved markets, is how it's been so parallel along the curve. Before she started speaking today, for example, we had a 133.2 and a 235.10. Both are now 2 basis points higher. So I don't see curve implications. In terms of the moonwalk notion, I really do think by doing less potential hikes and more balance sheet, I think that is a bit different scenario. And I do think the balance sheet issues could be put off in such a way, and she talked about emerging markets and global impact. I think that's what their consideration is, and I do think that's a bit watering down. I also think the normal rate that they now can place Fed funds has definitely been under review, especially if you look at some of the dot plots over the last several years. I think all of that taken together doesn't mean they're not going to continue to try, but I think it makes gradual a capital case. You know, capital letters, gradual, really gradual.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.